Lines are available, 521-8255. Guy, you're on CFRA. Good morning.
Good morning, Lowell.
Yep.
I've looked extensively at Mike's plan and read Joanne's article this morning in the Ottawa Citizen.
Joanne?
Chianello.
Okay.
And I think the Kanata line is a total winner. And I think that if Jim would have taken more than 2 minutes and listened to his people to respond, you might have a really good hybrid situation here that will bridge the gap for the next 25 years until Phase 3 gets to Kanata. And hear me out here. If Jim would have taken a few minutes to look at Mike's plan, both the Barrhaven line and the Kanata line are winners. In 2000...
Wait, excuse me. The Kanata line. What are you talking about?
Well, the one that comes in on the 17 tracks... that comes from March Road that goes into Bayview Station.
Oh, the one that goes right through Carp.
Yeah, I call it the 17 line because it uses the 17.
Okay, it doesn't really go through Kanata. Okay.
Yeah, so that, in essence, is a total winner for Matt Muirhead and for Mike McGuire. Because if Jim would have taken a little bit of time, that line for $25 or $35 million could have a life expectancy of 20, 25 years and bridge the gap until LRT Phase 3 comes through. So I asked Jim Watson to please take more than 2 seconds and use cheap politics and a cheap napkin comment to look at using existing infrastructure to solve some of our city's problems.
Now, you say
today.
That Chianello, her article is wrong on some of the facts.
Okay, well, yeah, let's look at it. She's looking at the wrong line. So on the Kanata line, she states that there is 3 at-grade crossings at Greenbank, Woodruff, and Merivale. Well, she's got the wrong line, Lowell. She's using the Toronto line, which is at grade at those 3 things. But the last time I checked, the 17 line has 3 bridges at Greenbank, Woodruff, and Merivale. As you know, anybody who travels those 3 roads goes
yes.
under those bridges all the time.
That's right.
So she's got the wrong line. She should maybe look at a map before she writes these articles. But let's look at the actual positivity of the Kanata line. This is an excellent, excellent bridge for Kanata commuters to get into the core for a low amount of money until Jimmy's Cadillac is built in 2034. So I'm hoping that Marianne Wilkinson and Matt Muirhead can use this as a debate because Mike's done some good building blocks.
So what you're saying here, I think, is that despite or what we plan to do with Stage 2 or Stage 3, what we should do in the interim, at the very least, is activate that Kanata line.
Absolutely. As well, what I would suggest to Mike is add a station at Moody because Bell's Corners desperately needs revitalization.
Yeah.
And as you said, it brings up the real estate values of any area that has an LRT station.
That's right.
So if you put an LRT station at Moody where there is an at-grade crossing, Joanne, which she missed, then that would be huge for Bell's Corners.
You see,
a park and ride. You have city-owned lands right there, Lowell.
That's all
city-owned land. They could do a park and ride there. And as you said, corral the people to using light rail by giving them a logical option.
See, I would use that line myself.
In a second. Yeah, that would be perfect for you. You just drive to Moody and boom in on a
train.
Well,
no, actually, I would just drive to Carp.
Yeah.
Presumably, there would be a park and ride at Carp. I'd just drive to Carp. Park my car there, get on it, and come right downtown.
Yeah, exactly. And again, as that other gentleman so aptly said, look at the traffic. You see, they talk about, it only produces 3,200 or 6,400 rides a day. You only need to bring people in at 2 points in the day, in the morning and at night. You know what I mean?
I think what's important, what you're saying here, you're opening some minds, I hope, is that despite what we plan to do with Stage 2 or 3, because we're many years in, Stage 2 probably will not see for another 15, 20
years. Well, actually,
years.
Stage 3 is where Kanata comes in.
Kanata's right.
Not even in Stage 2.
So in the interim, at the very least, no matter what we plan to do with light rail, let's at the very least activate that Kanata line.
You know what, Jim, come on. You know, you've got good ideas are not exclusive to liberals. Open up your mind and open up some consultation and some dialogue. Don't forget that the city-owned lands that we acquired in 2006 when we did press the reset button on the north-south on the Barrhaven line are still there to be used. So as far as I'm concerned, Jan Harder should be on this too, saying, you know what, this Barrhaven line is a real winner because Barrhaven's the fastest growing community and it uses the existing rail lines, it even uses the existing stop. So for $50 million, you can get people into the Bayview station. Now, I do agree with Joanne that the Orleans line is not a winner, and the Riverside South is gonna really mess up the O train. But you know what? From a Western standpoint, for $50 million to give 25 years bridge until Jimmy's Cadillac is built? Come on, Jim. Don't just flippantly say it's written on the back of a napkin. We spend all this money on consultations and debates and everything else, and at election time he comes out in 15 minutes and gives a comment like that. That's not leadership.
Thank you for the call. Got lines available. Five to what? I think Guy's making a very good point. I hadn't thought of this, that there is that line. Some of you may know the line. It goes right through. If you went to the Carp Fair along the Carp Road, you drove over that line. It's right there just before you arrive at the intersection at Carp. It goes right through March Road, all of the industrial complex there, the high tech, etc., etc. Goes right through a corner of Kanata, so it would be available to residents of Kanata, etc. Why not, despite what else we do, why not activate that? 521-8255. We'll be back, CFRA.